Welcome to episode 4, and Pastor Brett has given me another word for this week that he wants me to share with you. And he said, Miss Emily, I'm going to come and just place it in your mailbox so that nothing happens to it. So here it is. Here's our word right there, right in the mailbox. So do you want to know what it is? Let's see. Oh, it's getting really windy out here. Oh my goodness, not again! That was a tough one. That wind picked up quick. Okay. Do you want to know what the word is now? Hello?
Well, I'm Zacchaeus.
What are you doing in that sycamore tree?
Well, I had someone I wanted to see.
Well, you come down right now. I think someone's coming to your house today.
Oh, good deal. Okay, I'll be right down.
What can I do for you?
Well, you're just a wee little man, aren't ya?
Hey! I guess I am a wee little man.
Well, so I don't know why you're climbing our sycamore tree, but I'm trying to help the kids of Wildwood with their word for the day.
Well, sycamore trees are made of wood. So what's up with this Wildwood?
Well, Wildwood is a church, and we worship the Lord Jesus there. And so we're trying to learn more about him and his word. And so we choose words that help us learn more about him.
Okay. Well, maybe I can help.
Okay.
I know a lot about Greek.
Oh.
So maybe I can help you.
Okay. Do you guys want to know what the word is? We haven't even found the word yet for today. Oh. It's very exciting. Oh, wow. Our word for the day, kids, is purpose.
Ooh.
Purpose. Do you know anything about that word, Zacchaeus?
Let me see this word. Oh, yeah. I think in Greek, this word means to aim or to scope. Yeah, to aim or to scope.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
That's what the Greek means, huh?
Yeah, I think you should use that. Yeah, a lot of times the English word means a lot of things in Greek, but we just pick which one we like the best. So I think scope works well.
Scope?
Sure.
Okay. Well, sometimes we double check with our friend named Glasses Man, and he really looks into the Bible, and he tries to see how the Bible defines a word.
Okay.
So maybe we should double check with Glasses Man to see what he thinks.
That sounds like a plan.
All right. Well, I thank you, Zacchaeus, and I think you might be in the wrong sycamore tree.
Well, I've been waiting up there for about 4 weeks.
Oh, wow.
So.
I didn't notice you up there. That's interesting.
All right. Well, I'll take my wee little legs, and we'll get to the next sycamore.
Okay.
All right.
Bye.
See you later. Bye. Good luck.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
Hey, glasses man.
Hey, Miss Emily.
How are you doing today?
I'm just okay. Not good.
Oh man, I'm sorry to hear that. What's going on?
Just nothing's been really going right this week for me. Just really down about it.
Aw, I am sorry to hear that. You know, when I'm down, I like to read God's word and pray, and usually I feel encouraged by that. And you know what? I just noticed you don't have your glasses on. Have you been looking through your spiritual glasses to see what God has to say about your life?
You know, Miss Emily, I haven't. Let me see where they're at. Hold on just 1 second.
Okay.
I found them. Ugh, they're dirty though. They got too much dust on it. And
oh my goodness. You've been leaving those on the counter all week, it looks like.
I haven't been wearing them like I should be. Let me try it on, okay?
Okay.
Wow. I've got a lot to be thankful for.
Are you feeling better?
I feel so much better already.
Oh, that is so good. So listen, the reason I'm calling is because the kids at Wild Arrows need your help again. Can you help us?
I'd be glad to.
Okay. So I found this weird dude sitting in my tree named Zacchaeus, of all things. And so he was telling me about our word. And he was talking to me about the Greek, saying that our word meant something else in Greek. But I said, you know what? I want to talk to Glasses Man about this and see what the Bible has to say. So our word for this week is purpose. And
purpose.
He said, yeah, purpose. And he said that the word meant aim or scope. What do you think the Bible has to say?
You know, we don't need other languages or other things to define what God's word says, because we have God's word itself, and that's perfect. How about we look at 2 Corinthians 9:7? I'll read that here to see what it says. Every man, according as he purposeth in his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver.
That's good. So purpose really is the things that God gives us a desire for when we're seeking His word and His ways.
Yes, absolutely correct, Miss Emily.
All right. Well, thanks, Glasses Man. And hey, don't forget your glasses anymore.
Makes a big difference with my spiritual glasses.
Indeed. Bye.
Bye.
Hey, Wild Arrows, welcome back to our lesson for this week. I'm so happy to have you all listening in, and I'm excited about what I have to share with you today from God's Word. We're talking today about the word purpose and how we can purpose in our heart to do things to serve and follow and glorify God. Did you know that God created you in a special way? If you have your Bible with you, turn to Psalm 139, that is. And if you don't, go ahead and pause, just like always, and find your Bible and bring it back with you so that you'll be able to follow along with us as we read. Psalm 139:14 says, I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well. I think it's so cool to hear that God made each of us fearfully and wonderfully. In our lesson today, we're going to look at someone else who was also fearfully and wonderfully made, and who was given a purpose when he came to know his Savior. I'd like you to meet today a man named Saul. If you take a look over here next to me, I've got a little drawing of him. And he's on the road to Damascus. And we're going to find out in a little bit why Saul's going to Damascus and what exactly happened to him while he was there. So again, if you have your Bible, this time we're going to move to the New Testament, to the book of Acts and chapter 9. All right, so when we first meet Saul, it's actually back in Acts chapter 7. And in that scene, we see Saul standing by and watching as Stephen is stoned. And what you're going to learn is that things are about to change for Saul, and God's going to get his attention in a very big way, because God has a purpose for Saul. In Acts chapter 9, we're starting in verse 1. And Saul, yet breathing out threatenings and slaughter against the disciples of the Lord, went unto the high priest, and desired of him letters to Damascus to the synagogues, that if he found any of this way, whether they were men or women, he might bring them bound unto Jerusalem. You've got Saul right here. He's ready to find followers of Christ, and he wants to bring them bound to Jerusalem. He's been persecuting Christians all this time. And as he journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly there shined round about him a light from heaven. And he fell to the earth and heard a voice saying unto him, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? And he said, Who art thou, Lord? And the Lord said, I am Jesus whom thou persecutest. It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks. So as Saul's traveling to Damascus, we learn that he's been behaving kind of like a stubborn donkey by kicking against the pricks, by persecuting Christians. As Jesus says, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? We learn that Saul is really persecuting Jesus. So you see, we have here a man, Saul. He's definitely not purposing in his heart to follow or serve God, at least not the true God of Jesus. But as he heads to Damascus, where he plans to continue persecuting Jesus' followers, he has a life-changing encounter with Jesus. He goes from persecuting Christians to purposing to give his life to preaching the gospel. As we read on, we learn, and starting in verse 6, and he, trembling and astonished, said, Lord, what wilt thou have me to do? And the Lord said unto him, Arise, and go into the city, and it shall be told thee what thou must do. And the men which journeyed with him stood speechless, hearing a voice, but seeing no man. And Saul arose from the earth, and when his eyes were opened, he saw no man. But they led him by the hand and brought him into Damascus. And when he was 3 days without sight, and neither did eat nor drink. And there was a certain disciple at Damascus named Ananias, and to him said the Lord now in a vision, Lord in a vision, Ananias. And he said, Behold, I am here, Lord. And the Lord said unto him, Arise and go into the street which is called Straight, and inquire in the house of Judas for one called Saul of Tarsus. For behold, he prayeth, and hath seen in a vision a man named Ananias coming in and putting his hand on him that he might receive his sight. Then Ananias answered, Lord, I have heard by many of this man how much evil he hath done to thy saints at Jerusalem. See, even Ananias, he doesn't know about going to see this Saul guy because he's heard that this man's been persecuting the followers of Jesus. And here he hath authority from the chief priest to bind all that call on thy name. But the Lord said unto him, Go thy way, For he is a chosen vessel unto me to bear my name before the Gentiles and kings and the children of Israel. For I will shew him how great things he must suffer for my name's sake. And Ananias went his way and entered into the house, and putting his hands on him said, Brother Saul, the Lord, even Jesus, that appeared unto thee in the way as thou camest, hath sent me, that thou mightest receive thy sight and be filled with the Holy Ghost. And immediately there fell from his eyes as it had been scales, and he received sight forthwith, and arose and was baptized. What an amazing story of a man who goes from persecuting Christians to a life-changing encounter with Jesus, where he purposes to give his life to preaching the gospel and leading people to Christ, no matter the cost. Later on, Saul's name becomes Paul, and God even uses him to write down much of the New Testament for us. When I was 12, I had an encounter with Jesus too. It wasn't quite as dramatic as Paul's. There was no blinding light, and I didn't lose my sight for 3 days, but I did realize at that time that I was a sinner and that I was separated from God. I chose that day to trust Christ and his death, burial, and resurrection alone to save me from my sins. I started from then on by purposing in my heart to learn the Word of God. As I've grown as a Christian, and I don't always do it perfectly, but I'm thankful that God has helped me to purpose in my heart now to give of my time, of my finances, of my home, and my other resources to serve him and let him work through me. I'm truly at my best when I'm letting God use me and purposing in my heart to do the things that he has for me and to do them cheerfully. I hope that this week you'll purpose in your heart to give of your time, of your money, and of your talents to serve God and love the people around you with joy. I hope you have a great week, and I can't wait to hear how it goes.
Welcome back to WKM. We are on day 1611 of quarantine. Man, I'm starting to enter the I can't take this anymore phase. I got to thinking about the Dudleys. I think we should check in with them and see how quarantine life is going with 6 kids.
We will now go live to our field reporters, Mariah and Lydia. Mariah and Lydia, can you hear me? Give us a scoop of how the quarantine has affected your house.
From the Dudley home here, everything's going completely normal. We've had a couple of boy nados and a slight chances of some dirty laundry here and there. We've also had a couple of random acts of kindness, like helping with the dishes.
Oh yeah, there has been helping with the dishes and picking up dirty laundry.
But now back to you, Max.
Wow, I guess I'm the only one going crazy after all.
Ryan, Lydia, could you report on your garden?
Thanks, guys. Today we're going to be talking about preparing a garden. So, as you can see, we have a raised garden. So, we have to put in some dirt, and we put in a couple of secret ingredients. Peat moss, and the special one is manure, which is what my brother smelled like after 3 days without a shower. You just spread it around, mix it up, kind of, and you're ready to go. But you should probably wait till around May 10th, which is usually the last frost. So if there's any frost, you should probably cover up your plants so there isn't a ton of tumbleweed flying around. We also will be planting our garden this week, and we'll be planting some tomatoes, lettuce, zucchini, herbs, and a couple of other things, and vegetables. We'll keep you guys updated as the plants start to grow, back to you guys.
I'm excited to see the fruit grow in that garden. We will have to check back in and talk about the harvest.
Let's take a look at how our service challenges went this week.
I can be a good steward of my time by setting up a gym night for my family.
You hop through these, then ride this to the next thing, and then throw all the balls in here, and then you play catch.
Okay, I think I got it. So every other foot in the spaces, right? I got it, I'll figure it out. I'm an athlete.
Steward of my talents, because I helped groom my dog. And it looks like a dog exploded in here.
My dog counted.
What are you doing, Max?
Making coffee cake.
Who are you making it for?
My sisters and my mom.
Cool.
Hitting the bullseye time and time again.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Dad jokes.
Dad jokes who?
Dad jokes who wanna make you cry.
I'm reading a book about anti-gravity. It's impossible to put down.
For this dad joke, I need an assistant.
I'm thirsty.
Hi, thirsty, I'm Dad.
My favorite dad joke is, I once was addicted to the Hokey Pokey, and then I turned myself around.
That joke is about a boomerang. I once forgot how to use a boomerang. Then it came to me, literally.
Don't trust Sam's. They make up everything.
I is 6, afraid of 7.
Why? I don't know why.
Because 7, 8, 9! Where did the king keep his armies?
I don't know.
Where? In his sleeves!
And I'm going to do a joke for WyldeArrows. How do you make a mouse smile?
I don't know.
Say cheese!
It's Colin.
My name is Brendan.
And we're going to do a joke for WyldeArrows.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Interrupting cow.
Interrupting
Boo.
Cow.
I'm going to do a joke for WyldeArrows. What did the mouse say to the cheese? I cheese you.
So silly.
I have always told my kids, never trust stairs. They're always up to something.
Spring is here. I'm so excited. I wet my plants.
Well, that was the most I've laughed in a while.
Me too.
This week, we are supposed to focus on our purpose. That is some deep thinking.
You aren't kidding. What is our purpose?
Our purpose is to bring God glory. We have been learning how to do that over the last few weeks.
That's true. We learned how to be a servant, how to serve our neighbors, and how to be a good steward of the things God has blessed us with.
Next week, we want you to send in questions for Pastor Brett.
That's right. The man himself will be appearing on Wild Arrows to answer your questions. You can ask him anything.
You won't want to miss Pastor Brett answering all the questions we have for him.
That's going to be good. I'm going to ask him how many bowls of Cocoa Pebbles he eats in a week.
I'm going to ask him who is his favorite church member.
You won't want to miss next week's episode. After we talk to Pastor Brett, we are going to release our butterflies into the world.
Now, let's take a look at our teacher shout-outs.
Hi, my little Wild Arrows. It's Miss Kim, your most favorite teacher from church, right? Right? Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, I just want to take a minute and say how much I miss you guys, and I hope you're all doing well, and I can't wait to see everybody back at church. And to put forth a little challenge, if you can remember my favorite song, I want to see videos of everybody singing my favorite kids song, and there will be a special prize for anybody who can do it. I love you guys. I can't wait to see you again. Mwah. Bye.
Hi, Wildwood boys and girls. We love and miss you.
Hope you're enjoying watching Wild Arrows with Miss Emily and Miss Melanie. And, of course,
Mr. Glasses Man and Mr. Webster. He's kind of cool, too.
As you can tell, we've enjoyed watching it with Claire, Ethan, and Danny. And we're excited for you guys to meet Maverick and Jack, our two newest grandsons.
And also, are you guys doing your good chores, taking out the garbage, giving your moms lots of hugs?
We love you. Okay. See you later.
Bye-bye. Oh, before we go, now listen, I can't wait to give you all a boom when you're going from class to class. And remember, Finn, don't be booming me so hard my hand hurts. All right, guys. Take
Bye.
Care.
Love you.
Thanks for tuning in. We will see you on the flip side. WKN, signing off.